This horse trainer voice is Heidi McLaughlin of fearlessrider.com. She's also the author of Kick Your Fear of Horses. Thank you for being a horse trainer voice, Heidi.
Thank you.
Tell us about Fearless Rider. What does that mean and how did it come about?
We want a connection with our horses. We want a relationship. Majority of us have fear issues. And for me, I was in fear for most of my life. And then when I got my first horse, at 39 years old, I found out I was in over my head and I was terrified. And I couldn't find the secret to relaxing in the saddle, to becoming a one with my horse, to have a relationship, because I was so uneasy. The reason I couldn't be a good rider, because it wasn't that I didn't try to take lessons, because I did. I couldn't absorb anything that anyone was teaching me, because when we are in fear, our mind is blocked, which means anything that someone's trying to teach us just rolls right off. It does not sink in because we're in self-preservation mode.
You were talking about or mentioned about you grew up with fear. You've always had, up until you got a horse, this fear of horses. What brought that about?
We had a grandfather or grandmother or father or somebody put us on a horse. They say, kick to go, pull back to stop, and you know, you're good to go.
And don't fall off.
And when we realized that not all horses were going to fit into that little mold and be perfect whenever we asked them to, we weren't taught how to handle them. So for me, I was 8 years old, and my grandmother's horse ran off with me and ran all the way back to the barn, and I was just screaming hysterically. So it was never talked about. No one ever said, well, this is what you did wrong, and this is what you should do differently. It was as if it didn't happen. Everybody kind of chuckled about it, but it was never dealt with. So I knew these were big and powerful animals, and they could hurt you, and that was in the back of my mind through my whole childhood, all the way till I was an adult.
What led you to wanting to overcome this fear when you said you got your, finally, before your 40th birthday, you got your first horse. What was it that made you decide, I'm going to do that and overcome this fear?
It was not long when I realized I was completely in over my head. I didn't even know how to cinch up, where's the saddle go, more forward, more back, how far are my stirrups supposed to be? It was so much detail that I didn't know. For years, I tried to hide it. And then, you know, the more we stuff things, the more they want to spew out, right?
Sure.
And I'd stuff the fear and just try to suck it up. So every time a horse scared me, I sold it, went down the road, I sold it, boom, get another one. Then the new trainer, oh, you want one of my horses? Oh, you don't need that saddle, you need this bit, you need this. And it was just this constant, nothing was like, this is how you do it. Everybody had their own method.
And nobody was approaching it from the point that you had the fear of putting your foot in that stirrup.
Everybody just get on. And that would be like me telling my grandson at his first swimming lesson to jump off the high dive without teaching him how to swim first. So I started to realize and started peeling back the layers and realized that if somebody would just show me from the beginning and I could work on it, because that's how our mind works. It's on the building of small accomplishments.
Well, you're talking about a person or your personal approach to horses, just as a horse trainer would approach the horse. You have to work with a foundation and build them up to the point where they can trust you and you can trust them. We always hear the horses know that fear. They feel it in you.
And I call that the vicious cycle.
Yes. What made you get to the point where you identified that this is something that you can train to others? In your book, Kick Your Fear of Horses, what led you to that point where you said, you know what, I need to put this down in a book?
I do have a degree in journalism, and I was a published writer and had done many feature stories for a lot of different publications.
So you knew how to write.
I did know how to write, and I did want to write a book. And I remember telling my husband when I was about 3/4 of the way through the book, I'm just Heidi from Fallbrook, California. Who's going to care that I wrote this? And he said, if you helped one person, would it be worth it? And I said, well, yes. And he said, well, then continue, which is exactly what I did. I thought, okay, all I want to do is put this information out there, let people know if I could do it and as afraid as I was, anybody could do it. but it's one of the greatest accomplishments I feel of my life. And I gave birth to 3 sons.
And that's a challenge in its own.
So I went ahead and decided to start to write the information. The funny thing was, is how my first 3-day clinic came up, is that a group of women came up to me at an expo and they said, if we paid you, there's a group of us ladies, there's like 6 of us, and if we paid you, would you show us how to do it? And I kind of cocked my head and thought, well, I guess, you know. And then I perfected it and perfected it over the last 7 years. And if I was to put it in a nutshell, I have to teach them how to ride intellectually instead of emotionally with fear. I had one woman, she showed up late. I said, you know, it's okay. And she said, I had to have my husband keep pulling over so I could throw up, because she was so scared on the way to the clinic. Stood on that mounting block for 20 minutes crying as I had to talk her on that horse. And at the end of the 3rd day, she's cantering and smiling and saying, I can't believe I'm doing this. It's not that I'm so great. It's that I figured out how to break this down. You know, if people are afraid, there's something missing in their training. There's something that they're not good at that is keeping them from becoming the rider they need to be, so that they aren't afraid and they're supporting their horse. So I teach a method that I can break down this fear. I can put the exercises in small, non-threatening increments that we just work on until they're good at that, and then we move on to the next. I can't throw everything at them at once. Their right. brain can't go there yet.
You can't do that with a horse either.
Right. I approach fear with people the same way I approach fear with horses. You make them comfortable, and you teach them slowly, step by step, and make them trust you and the process.
That is absolutely fascinating, Heidi. This is the Horse Trader Voice, and I want to thank our guest, Heidi McLaughlin, for joining us here. Thanks for being a Horse Trader Voice, Heidi.
Thank you.